Hello everyone. In case you want to extend your Wi-Fi network and you don't have a mesh system or your Wi-Fi router doesn't support mesh nodes, you basically have two options. Either you use a dedicated Wi-Fi extender or you use a router that you put in extender mode and you configure it so to extend your Wi-Fi network. So in this video, I'll be answering the following question. Is it better to use a dedicated Wi-Fi extender to extend your Wi-Fi network, or is it better to use a router that you put in Wi-Fi extender mode to extend your Wi-Fi network? And to be able to get accurate results for my comparison, I chose two devices from Tenda that are Wi-Fi 6 and that has the same Wi-Fi speed. So this is the Tenda Wi-Fi extender model A23. It is an AX1500 Wi-Fi extender, and this is the Tenda RX2 Pro Wi-Fi router that is also AX1500. So that being said, let's go now and start the tests. This first test will show us the sheer speed of each device, and here I have two PCs connected with Wi-Fi 6 on the 5 GHz band on the extended network, and you saw here that the router is much faster than the dedicated extender, and it is averaging 17.3 megabytes per second copy speed, and it copied the 6.24 gigabytes file in only 5 minutes 51 seconds, whereas the dedicated extender took 9 minutes and 27 seconds to copy the same file, and it was averaging a speed of 11 megabytes per second only, and I repeated this test many times. Now I'm testing the internet speed without any load on my internet connection. I have an internet connection speed of 120 megabits per second download and 20 megabits per second upload. And here both devices are giving the expected speed, which is 120 megabits per second, with a slight advantage for the router that is giving 130 megabits per second download speed. Now I'm performing an internet speed test with my internet connection loaded. So I have two TVs streaming 4K movies, I have also two iPads playing Full HD videos, and I have my Amazon Echo playing music. And here you notice that both devices give almost the same speed, which is approximately 85 megabits per second, and this is very good. So now I'm performing the range test. To be able to get accurate results, I put both devices at exactly the same place, and I live in an apartment building. So I went out of my apartment into the hallway and then into the stairwell, and at approximately 60 yards mark, both devices started cutting, and the router that was configured in extender mode was still giving 21 megabits per second before it cut, whereas the dedicated extender was only giving 9 megabits per second download speed before it cut. And this is a clear advantage for the router. Now that you saw the speed test and the range test, you saw that the router that is working in extender mode is better in all the tests than the dedicated extender. It is better by a little bit, but in every test it was outperforming the dedicated extender. Now, would this mean that it is better than the dedicated extender if you want to extend your network? Not necessarily. For instance, the dedicated extender is much easier to set up. It's almost plug and play, and it's much also convenient to use. It has only one plug. You just plug it in the wall and then you forget about it. Whereas for the router, you need to configure it more, and also it is bulkier than the dedicated extender. It needs a power cord and you need to find a place for it so to install it. Other advantages that play in the favor of the router is that it is future-proof, so it can be repurposed if you don't need it as a Wi-Fi extender. And also it has another advantage, the fact that it has many physical ports so that you can connect devices to this router even when it is used as a Wi-Fi extender, whereas this dedicated Wi-Fi extender has only one physical port and you can use it also to connect your devices to it. By the way, if you want to check out any of these Tenda devices, I'm going to leave an Amazon affiliate link in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you, and this will help my channel greatly. I hope that you liked this video and you found it useful. In case you did, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give this video a thumbs up. I want to thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.